just bear with me, I'm just going to ask you to do one thing for me. And that one thing is to please stand on God's word. If you would please stand in the reading of God's word. I will be reading from the King James Version and also the NIV Version. And the word of God reads this way. And I, brethren, when I came to you, you came not with excellency of speech or wisdom, declaring unto you the testimony of God. For I determined not to know anything among you, save Jesus Christ, him crucified. And I was with you in weakness and in fear and much trembling. And my speech and my preaching was not with enticing words of men's wisdom, but in demonstration of the Spirit and power of power, that your faith should not stand in the wisdom of man, but in the power of God. Amen. Now for the reading of the New International Version. And it reads, and so it was with my brother and sister, when I came to you, I did not come with eloquence or human wisdom, as I proclaim to you the testimony of God. For I resolved to know nothing while I was with you except Jesus Christ and him crucified. I came to you in weakness and with great fear and trembling. My message and my preaching were not with wise and persuasive words, but with the demonstration of the Spirit and power, so that your faith might not rest on human wisdom, but on God's power. You may be seated.
Amen.
If I would have a theme today, the theme would be, there's a great multitude. There's a great multitude. Amen? What is the job of a pastor? The job of a pastor is to feed God's people with knowledge and understanding. This is affirmed by God's word in the book of Jeremiah 3:15. And if you would journey with me, you would hear these words. And I will give you pasture according to my heart, which shall feed you with knowledge and understanding. Ezekiel 34, verse chapter 34, 32 reads, and I will set up one shepherd over them, and he shall feed them even my servant David, a prince among them, as I, the Lord, have spoken it. Amen. You see, God sends pastors to do what? He sent them to feed the sheep, which is allegory to describe action, meaning teaching his people, the living word of God, to perform the holy sacraments of holy communion and baptism, to give biblical counseling, to comfort the bereaved, visitations of the sick, and provide leadership to the congregation in accordance to God's will.
All right.
God has given me the spirit of proclaiming the good news and teaching the word. He never gave me the spirit of look at your neighbor. He never gave me the spirit of say yeah. He never gave me the spirit, like some may call me, charismatic with a lot of hoop and holler. But he gave me the word of truth to give to his people.
All right.
Like so many men of God in the past, up to today, God has sent me to make his word understandable to his people.
All right.
Today, Westminster Presbyterian Church, your prayers have been answered as my prayers have been answered as well. And together, we can do great things in the Lord. But we got to remember to seek God first in everything we do. There's a great harvest out there. A multitude of people who don't know the Lord.
Come on, bring it up.
There's a great to share what you come to understand in Christ.
Amen.
Today is a new day in the Lord that Westminster Presbyterian Church is spiritually renewed and refreshed to go and make disciples, reaching out to people. Amen. Start.